good fortune, I'm flanked by these two extraordinary musicians. So we have keys and we have conversations. Life can't get any better, can it? Anil, I'm wondering what I'm doing sitting here. I should be standing out of deference towards both of you.
She has this something sarcastic about this. I think something terrible is going to happen now.
I mean every word. But it's a pleasure to be chatting with both of you. You started this discussion about the fusion scene in India. I'm wondering if we can talk about that a little more. What is your opinion?
You want to start a controversy?
Yes.
Clearly.
Yes. Why not? Better ratings for the channel.
See, I don't know, fusion, like what we... like what he said and what he played and not what I sang, but what Ilaiyaraaja sir did in the 80s, that is real fusion. You know, he fused so many Carnatic ragas, he took so many Carnatic ragas and he had the most amazing string section arrangements. And that, you know, all of us just fell in love with it the minute we heard it. That is real fusion. And what Rahman did in the 90s is also true fusion. World music arrangements with Indian tunes. That is fusion. But fusion nowadays have descended to like...
Yeah, it's considered a bad word.
Well, that's also because I think it's just become as though, you know, two people from different styles, they just sit together and play anything they like. It's,
they don't practice. They just practice on stage. You know, that, and that is wrong, I think. You should take something and do it with reverence.
And then it's also, and it's also not fair to the audience, because the audience, if they're, you know, a ticket-paying audience...
That's what I think. I'll never go and...
jam on stage.
I'll go and attend a fusion concert like that, you know. I don't want people to just take you for granted and do something. I love Shakti, what they did. They come up with pieces, they compose pieces, and that is fusion.
And they've been working together.
They've been working
together. But I think if two musicians sort of understand each other and are in sync with each other's thinking, why not jam? I mean, what's wrong about that? Because what's
jam about... in the jam at home, and then ideas start flowing in, and then you a little bit of concretize
exactly.
Then go present proper compositions, and then jam. After that, it's okay. But
I agree,
you can't,
because I think that, you know, you can't use the stage as your laboratory.
So have you both been working on any piece together?
No. We've been working on disturbing the peace for everybody around us.
So let's have some disturbance.
No, we've it's been a dream project for both me and for Srini, and I can speak for him on this and say that we've been wanting to work together. And I've always visualized him with a grand piano setting. I'm so glad that thanks to you, we are actually...
I'm very happy to be here, because I really admire what he does. And I wanted to do something along with him, do an album, do a concert, nothing but... Nothing is really
taken off so far, but I mean, I plan to live for a long time.
This is the catalyst.
I plan to live for a long time, and I'm sure
he
does
too.
So it'll happen.
Let's hear a song in celebration of this moment that you're both.
Before I get to that, I want to point out that Srini, especially because he himself was a part of the very prestigious November Fest, where he brought together, brought alive all those Hindi film songs of yesteryear on stage. And it's not necessarily songs that he has sung. These are all songs that we all know. And Srini has brought me to a beautiful composition that he has sung on screen for Alage Sugama. I forget the movie.
Parthale
Parvasam and Rahman's music. And that was originally, it's a song composed in the Carnatic mode with Ragam Sahana as the main thing which Srini has sung. And
some chords are
amazing
in that,
In fact, I think it's we'll play that. And Srini has played with that composition in such a beautiful way that at one point the Sahana becomes Brijavanti, which is another very beautiful. It's actually an North Indian ragam that's coming. I don't think it's ignorance at all. He's always like this.
Yes.
In fact, let's play that, because it's Arage Sugama. Is that in D or any other scale?
Arage Sugama.